Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of How to Create, where we take a mod and break it down to bite-sized pieces so that it's a little easier to understand. Yes. But yeah, we are going to be working on some things today. I'm going to show you a little bit of difference. We already made the andesite funnels, and we used them right over here, and they're really cool because they allow you to drop stuff, take stuff out of a chest, put stuff into things, into chests, etc., etc. But there is a better version. Now that we have brass, and I showed you how to do the brass, we're going to get to making a brass funnel. And brass funnels and brass parts are more versatile. So in order to do that, we're going to need a thing called this thing, whatever that thing's called, electron tube. We're gonna need an electron tube. In order to make an electron tube, you're gonna have to go to the nether and get some nether quartz. You're gonna have to have done some mining and get some redstone. Put them all together in a table like this, and we get stuff called rose quartz. Rose quartz, then, if we take a piece of paper, which again, three of your sugar cane in a row, in a table, gives you some paper. Paper and a piece of sand will give you sandpaper. And then what you do with this stuff is you take the sandpaper or the rose quartz, you put them in your offhand, which mine looks funny because I'm in creative. One in your offhand, one in there, you just basically right click. And each sandpaper will do 8 of these quartz, and it turns it automatically. I thought we already did this thing already, but I guess not. It'll do 8 of them before it runs out. It makes polished rose quartz. Polished rose quartz, we then stick together with a plate, an iron plate or iron sheet, and that gives us our electron tubes. Now we take our electron tubes, our brass, and our dried kelp put together, and we get one of these things right here. Brass tunnels, and I just got 64 of them. Now, the brass tunnels were really, really cool. I'll show you some things on the brass tunnels. Let's just make another setup right here. We'll just do another little quick setup right here to kind of demonstrate how these work. I need a shaft. Let me get a shaft. Thank you. I'm going to use these creative motors because, yeah, why not? I could make water wheels and do all those crazy things, but this is just to demonstrate. So we're gonna go ahead and make that move. There we go. Put a shaft down here and put another shaft right here. We'll put a chest down here, something just to move stuff around a little bit with. We'll put one there. We're gonna need a belt for this, obviously. Okay, don't do that, sir. Why would you do that? Go in there. We need a belt. Let's get a belt here. There to there, we got a belt moving. And if I put a chest up here, I'm thinking I can do that. Put a chest here and a chest here. Let's just demonstrate these funnels. All right, then we put a funnel on here. I can put this funnel on there and this funnel on there. And one cool thing about the funnels are, you can go right up to the center up here. See where that little X is right there? You can focus that and scroll wheel. And basically what that does is, if it's on the asterisk, it's basically in up to a stack of an item coming out. If you wanted to limit this and say, okay, I only wanted 16 of something coming out. Remember, the andesite funnels only do one. If we put a stack of something in here like these, it doesn't really matter. It will bring out stacks of 16. So 4 stacks, and we got it transferred. I mean, I generally leave this thing all the way down to infinity, and it will move an entire stack at one time. This is... Nope, that is not what I meant to do, sir. Get off of there. It will move an entire stack at one time. One go. There's an entire stack. Boom. And if I had multiple stacks in there, it would move multiple stacks. So these things are really, really cool. Another function of these things is that you can actually say, okay, Mr. Guy, I only want you to input this rose, unpolished rose quartz. Now if I put stuff in here, and I say I put this stuff in there, boom, go. Oh, it can't go. It can't go because it doesn't match the filter. And there is another filter, really stupid easy to make. I should have got some of those out. Right here, you can filter things with a piece of wool and everything. Let's just, okay, you're not gonna, I did that wrong. Let me do it here. Filter. Yeah, let me grab one of these out. Boom, 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 done, got it. You can take a filter, if you hold it in your hand and right click, it opens up this stuff. You can say, yep, I want you to let iron go in, I want you to let slabs go in, and I want you to let andesite alloy go in. Okay, so if I do that, I pop this filter on there like that. Now, the andesite, that's not going to work because the andesite is still not part of the group. But I've told it andesite alloy is okay. I've told it slabs are okay, and I've told it iron's okay, right? So all of these things are going to go through fine and dandy and go right in there. So if I have multiple things. Now, where this comes in really, really handy, I will show you. If I go up here and I get an encased fan like this. Let's get rid of you. And let's put the encased fan. Where do I want to put this thing? Right here-ish. If right at the end of the belt, we put an encased fan right there, only that doesn't go that way. We can rotate things, but I don't have my wrench, do I? I do have a wrench. Let's grab a wrench. Let's rotate this thing. There we go, perfect. And then I'm gonna use one of the motors here because again, I can set up a water wheel, I can set up a windmill, I can set up a lot of things. This is for demonstration purposes. There we go, you see it's blowing that direction. And if I take a couple of slabs, which I had some in here, and I go, where do I want to go? Where's the slabs, sir? There they are. Go there. Go there. We need a bucket of water. I happen to have one. Now, as you know, and later we'll find out, on an iron, like if you want to make iron, you need gravel, right? And you can wash gravel to get a chance at iron. Wash gravel, let's get a stack of that. Probably want to get more than that, but one stack would be fine. Alright, so I put gravel in here, and it comes out, and because it's not in the filter, it'll sit there to wash until that stack turns into, it used to be one of three things. I'm not sure. Let me look it up right quick. Gravel. I think it's three things. It comes iron nuggets, flint, and dead bushes, I believe. I think... Nope, it's just iron and gravel. It's just not gravel. It's iron and flint. So there it is. It washed it. Now, if I had it in this filter right here, which I don't have currently, if I put it in this filter... Now, it went in because I took the filter out. But if I filter this, take that, and put it in this filter, where did my filter go? There it is. Now, if I take my filter and I put these two in there, like that, put the filter back in there, and we take our gravel again. Okay, I'm in creative, no wonder. And I put my gravel back over here. Do I have any more gravel? I do not. Let me get some more gravel. Get some more gravel, and we take a stack of gravel, and we put it in there. Oh, how about put it on the belt, sir? Yeah, that would be great if you could put it on the belt. I mean, there we go. All right, we do that. If I take my iron and gravel out of here, iron nuggets, it'll sit there and wash until it becomes the flint and iron. And then it'll automatically go in. So it'll stand there and hold it till it washes. So if I had a production of, say, a cobble gin going into if I put a cobble gin going into a millstone or grinding wheels, and then it fed into a belt over to here, once it turned into iron, I've got an iron farm. And I've got iron and, of course, flint. Now, one of the nice things later on I'll show you is a tunnel where you can split this out using brass tunnels, and you split it out, and if you got two outputs, you know what they are, you can put two belts side by side and tell it to send the iron down this way and send the flint down this way. It works out really good. But that's what brass funnels are. Brass funnels are really, really, really super, 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 super exciting and important because you have the ability to filter, which is super important. And they're going to be fun to do. So there you go. The brass funnel is well worth getting into, well worth doing the steps. Again, to cover it one more time, we're going to make the unpolished rose quartz or the rose quartz itself. And then we're going to make sandpaper. We're going to take the sandpaper. We're going to polish the quartz. Once we do that, we take the polished quartz with a iron sheet. It makes the this guy right here, the electron tube. And then once you make the electron tube, you can then use some brass electron tube and all to make your brass funnels. You're going to really like the brass funnels. You're going to want to migrate towards brass things because they're more powerful. I showed you over here in another video how we make the brass. It's really super easy. And that's going to be it. That's going to be it for our little bite-sized chunk of doing things. I'm going to be using a lot of these later to just show us stuff. So thanks for watching, guys. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up. It does help us. And go ahead and subscribe and ring that bell. You'll get more notifications. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a great day. Bye.